Hi everyone, my name is Esther and I'm an executive officer at the Gillamii Centre, and this is incredible in Australia. I'm really privileged to be speaking to you today about my first virtual presentation. Today I'm going to speak to you about our project Community Carbon and Conservation, which forms really nicely into the last presentation. So a little bit about me, just try and describe the virtual space we're using to you today. I was up one of the small properties outside of Perth, and after the last school decided to study the bachelor of environmental science in Berlin. And then after finishing that, got off to the US to work with the National Park Service, launching upland education in Arizona. And then came back to Perth. I did a bit of indoor environmental consulting. That wasn't interesting enough to be funded up. So that's why that's a bit of a cost. And then in 2019, I decided to make the move to my partner's better environmental framework in South Gilbert, which is where I'm at today. So, as you can mention, I'm going to be speaking to you about our community carbon and conservation project. Just going to give you a bit of a project overview about the partner development and education, sort of where to next, and some key learnings. And on the key learnings, we just want to state that carbon farming or conservation sector. This presentation is really from the perspective of the nature facilitator and also landholder, point of view, and it's actually not really right in the family farm now. I just want to say that looking forward, because it is a very complex industry, and this is where this presentation is coming from. So to start off, the project is quite a large collaboration between four organisations and six dedicated farming families. I just want to spend some time talking about these partners. So the first is Gillamii Centre, who owns the farm in Bahama, and then Gillamii and Landcare, part of the business of conducting sustainable and resilient landscape. And our role in the project is really to move the community consultation planning and the protective ethics space. We also have our neighbouring land company, North Stirlings Natural Resources, who are probably referred to as NSPNR, and NSPNR aims to make a significant improved social, environmental, and economic region for current and future generations. And their role is much similar to ours, and the main goal is managing the land topic in their area as encompassed by the land. The third is our partner's threshold environmental. So, threshold environmental and restoration specialists do high-quality, large-scale ecological restoration, and they really focus on the most species in the right place, in the right combination, and really take our technological and scientific approach to the restoration. And their role is mainly managing two aspects of the carbon and the biodiversity. The organisational partner is the Gillamii program, and they're part of the government of Western Australia, and their program is to service and help to serve several practices and resources through community tourism roles. Really strong to actually obtain funding to help with the community education scientists as well as the protective sector. And last but certainly not least, are our six farming families. So they have set up their own interesting farm in Pallinup, in the south of Pallinup. It's one farm in Pallinup, northwest border, and two northwest. And the landholders are one of these projects is really actually providing the land and working with threshold and farm partners to establish the farms and understand the community challenge in green farmland, managing the carbon farming and paper management of the community. To the context of where we are, so we're located in the very southern part of southwest Western Australia, around the rain and the main countries as well, so the emergence of green space. Gillamii and NSP, we have like 1.2 million residents within the two groups, and sort of focusing three stars there, travel, and retail, and wildlife. The region is known for cropping, mixed and spice operations in some insects is fine, but also the area is very much in recognized biodiversity hotspot of southwest Western Australia. And we sort of focus around the Stirling range, which you can see in the second image on the right, one of the very managed areas in WA. But like many areas, we are also suffering some huge environmental losses from the rains and declining soil bed. Salinity is a massive issue for us with our major flats based in the Pallinup Mountains and shallow water tables, and just loss of biodiversity in general to the region. So I just wanted to take a look at some of that context now of where we are and what this amazing project can be. So this story is probably something that's not unfamiliar to most of the Landcare groups. The Landcare is in the blue. We have been there for a long time, obviously been suffering with these large-scale issues mentioned previously, but we're also massively overwhelming about farming and land managers wanting to more adequately implement and start addressing these large-scale issues about catchment levels. I have many people just trying to really hard to access resources currently, and wanting to get expertise to help to attack this problem, and also just at a scale where we can really start to see a change. And so I know with myself and our mentor, I'm going to start to see some of the biodiversity work in the online. And we decided to go on and talk about how we could collaborate and start to solve some of the issues. So we came up with a solution for life in our area, and that was to collaborate together to develop a large-scale biodiverse carbon restoration project. And like I mentioned earlier, I'm not an expert, I'm not going to focus on methodology and what the different options out there, but I just want to highlight the methodology that we're using, that we're using and what we're using, because as I said, I think there was a knowledge in the room in what is very complex industry. So to keep it quite simple, the process is sort of five major steps. So first is to identify what projects that you want to do. Then registering your project with the emission reduction fund, the EIF, then actually delivering the project with the benefit of having to pay it to borrow and pay it forward, and then reporting the progress of the project's progress, in both potentially co-benefit outcomes or also carbon sequestration, and then generating the funding credits based on that carbon sequestration. And threshold involvement, so we're covering that whole process from the project generation. And I just wanted to show you sort of the main areas that are the main groups that are involved, because it is difficult just in both itself knowing where you want to play in this space and how you want to support farmers when we are talking about the big farming times and financials, especially when we're in farming business and payments. So we've been really involved in the training, so sitting down, mostly farmers are coming to us, but sitting down with them, making sure that they're training, looking at their whole farming plan, looking at the areas that they're identifying as marginal, because everyone identifies marginal when it's very, very differently. So making sure they take the lead on identifying that within their farming enterprise and working with them to develop a really good plan between community-bound farming and we've been helping in the way of great because we've done two of the projects and we're going to come in and talk to next year to see how it comes to our community. And people from abroad as well, that's really where the grassroots are interested in what to do. And it's quite a lot of discussion because we do talk about diversified and kind of diversified the time of the draft is so prepared. There's, you know, a big discussion is to how about returning your credits in relation to what you want to do to bring them on. And so a little bit about what this actually looks like on ground, and the same marginal land, and the same community codes, so I've always been all that sort of stuff, I've been running through what that's been like for us to use the background. So just to highlight two properties in Bowl, the first thing is all of the property. The older property was 65 acres, environmental southern and vegetation southern last year, with a large restoration of the way to the lakes and the resources. And it required 6.5 kilometers of connection. And on this property, the farm is identified. The land has been marginal, basically, it was dangerous, so unproductive for cropping, but also at risk for soil erosion being compromised from this part of the farm. So what they've done is they've first got an actual saline lake system on an easter, protecting the wetland system there, and in our asset image, so they're really focusing on connectivity. So this piece of the land that connects to the channel lake that's in the north, we've got also connected to the Stirling National Park, so we're achieving a strategic point matching the marginal aspect with the environmental outcomes that we want. And this is within the backup wetlands, which is a landscape of national significance as well. Doesn't look like much from the area, which is funny, it's very impressive wetlands. And then and the next property, just to highlight, is the Duncan property. This property has a tributary road after the structure development that runs into one of our large wind systems, the Pallinup River. And this farm identified there has been vital to two reasons. One, just the underlying nature of the property, the mechanics of the land next to the river where it's subject to frost, quite simply, that's the reuse and performance in the output natural communities within. And then just if you can see, so this is a section there that we're going to be doing. The right here, I don't think, has all the profile. And it's just because that's just what we're going to be facing. It's just going to be trying to work out the farm. So this comes to 100% of the research. It's for the restoration area where we based on the consolidated we really want to focus on making sure that we don't have to stop this farm protected for that whole thing. So, this is a farm that is done down a lot, but it is quite complex, actually. It does involve farm planning and replanting of farm structures. So, that is something that is really not a big accelerated process. So, we're just going to focus on making sure we're going to stay in and consolidate what we think. Then, next, making sure we're achieving those biodiversity outcomes that we set out to. So, we really want to say it's really kind of a useful system that's going to diversity in terms of what we've been able to establish, but also just like to make sure we're able to have more ecosystem restoration and climate function on the target threshold,
tend to be unexpected from the beginning. The nature of the project is extremely controlled.
Thank you.